when should we stop self-diagnosing and get to
a proper doctor? Yes. Okay, great question. So let's go back to the fever thing. We talked about fever before. What we have here is acetaminophen, Motrin. We talked about fever. If your fever does not getting better with the use of fever-reducing medications, or is like super high, like 103, 104, or it lasts a few days, I'm kind of concerned because it may not be a cold. You could have pneumonia. You could have something else. And remember, that's our body's way of saying, whoa, something's wrong, and our body's way of trying to fight it off. So listen.
If you don't have a fever, if you just have your runny nose and your head feels all squishy.
Or if the fever goes away after 24 hours, which is really what I would expect.
Okay.
You'll get a fever with a cold.
So really the fever is the thing to look for.
It's the high fever that lasts, that doesn't go away, that seems a little bit worse than normal.
But if you're just drippy and goopy and you don't feel good, you can take just drugstore medicine.
You can, except for our next item. We're talking about the nose and talking about the drippy stuff. Okay, so we expect to have nasal congestion when it comes to colds, right? You know you're gonna be stuffy, we know that. However, if your nasal congestion lasts for 7 to 10 days or longer and is really goopy and you're like, gosh, this is not getting better, I'm just blowing and blowing and blowing, you might actually have a sinus infection.
Yeah.
So if you're 2 weeks and you're still blowing and blowing, please come see me.
I have a friend who's had one for like a month now.
That's what can happen, absolutely. And same thing, we talk about sinus infections. This can even extend further. These are the sinuses. I'll tell you about those in just a second. But if you got this nasal congestion, you got high fever, and then you get facial pain, we also worry about a sinus infection.
It goes into your jaw. It feels like your whole head is
your
like
your head sometimes feels like it's
horrible.
In a vice.
Yeah.
Now, the red areas are our sinuses. We've got sinuses behind our forehead, behind our cheeks, all over our face. And they really should be clear. They're air-filled, okay? That's important. But sometimes if they get swollen, bacteria and viruses can get in there and cause infection. And that's what a sinus infection is. Don't treat a cold for like 3 weeks saying, well, it's just a cold. After 3 weeks, it may not be just a cold, okay?
Right.
Moving on to the ear. A lot of people think ear infections are just for kids, but they're not. Ear infections, by the way, do happen in adults. And you see that little orange like line coming from the ear? That's the eustachian tube. That tube is to help us equalize pressure and drain the ears and things like that.
Right.
But if that gets swollen, then viruses and bacteria can kind of swim to the middle ear and cause an infection. So you got ear pain, get that checked out because you could have an ear infection because adults do get infections.
Yeah.
Oh, and by the way, there's something called double sickening. Have you ever had a situation where you have a cold and then like a week later you're like, oh, I feel better. And you're going on and then you're like a week after that, you're like, I think I'm sick again. You know what I'm talking about, right? It's called double sickening. And if you get that, you might very well have a bacterial infection that needs an antibiotic as opposed to just being a viral infection when it started. Okay, just so you know. Okay, the belly.
Ugh.
Okay, all right. Stomach stuff for me is always really tough. I hate being nauseous and stuff. But look, if you've got abdominal pain that wakes you up in the middle of the night or is so, it hurts so much you don't want to move or you don't want anyone to touch it, or maybe you are pregnant or you've had surgery or trauma, any of those situations in abdominal pain, please come see us. Just let us work it out, okay? That sounds pretty severe.
When should you go to urgent care versus an emergency room?
I love this question.
Bust it out.
As a primary care doctor.
Look, we even made props.
We have props. Okay, very quickly. Primary care should be your number one go-to for things that are not emergencies. Urgent care, people wonder when they should go. You go to urgent care for things you would go to your primary care doctor for, but when your primary care doctor is not available, okay? And then emergency room we go to for things that are limb or life-threatening, okay?
Right.
So keep that in mind. And we're doing this segment, and let me just tell you why we're doing this. I know I'm getting a little long-winded, but I gotta say this. There's urgent cares popping up everywhere, and it's a good thing. But sometimes what I'm seeing with my patients is that they're choosing to go to urgent care rather than coming to see me, and we want you to go to the right place. That's the point. UTI, urinary tract infection.
Sure.
So for this, you
too
go
much
to
information.
Your, you go to your primary care doctor. You could totally go to urgent care for this. This would be totally appropriate for urgent care. All right, let's move on to chest pains. What do you guys think? Chest pains.
Well, ER.
Okay, exactly. We said limb or life threatening, right? Okay. Let's move to something a little maybe trickier. Burns. I don't know. What do you say about that? Okay,
ER.
So it's either one. If you said either one, you're exactly right. Urgent care if it's a small burn, ER if it's a large burn or a very deep burn, okay?
Okay.
Moving on to pink eye, conjunctivitis, what do we think?
Ew, urgent care.
Urgent care, because we could go to our regular doctor. Severe headache, this is tricky. I'm gonna put this in the middle. If you got like the worst headache of your life, you got other symptoms and stuff, that's the ER. But if this is your normal migraine, you're otherwise healthy, you just need to see someone, possibly urgent care, it's going in the middle. Twisted ankle, you sprained your ankle. No, you can go to urgent care.
Okay.
Yeah, you can go to urgent care. Because even as family doctors, we treat that. But you can go to the ER too, but come to urgent care or your doctor. Okay. And you hit your head.
Oh, ER.
Yes, I love it, right? We want to make sure you don't have
concussions
or head injuries or things like that. And rashes, finally, rash.
Urgent care?
Urgent care, very
Yay!
Good.